What's going on, guys? Welcome to Chat or Phase Rain, coming at you guys with a brand new video here today. So today, I have a shoe collection video going up for you guys. The other day, I posted a picture of my closet, and I just posted, like, you know, this picture of, like, my shoes, I guess, and, like, them all racked in. I said, almost filling up. And I got a lot of tweets in, like, whoa, dude, you should do a shoe collection video, because I don't really, like, I guess, talk about the shit that I buy, or really, I just kind of, like, I mean, unless it's a car. But, like, I don't really talk about, like, the shoes I buy. I mean, I did that one time because Sneaker Access hooked it up with a few Yeezys. Like, I got this pair of Yeezys from them, and I got, like, three others. I put that in a vlog on my channel. But I normally don't, just because, like, there's no reason. I don't even, like, Snapchat any of the shoes I get. But a lot of people actually did request it, so I thought, let's show them the shoes. So we got all the shoes behind me. I stacked them up, and let's go through them. Because if you guys don't know, I'm a size 15. Like, my shoe size is 15. Sometimes I have to get 14s, but they're usually pretty uncomfortable. But it's mad hard for me to find shoes that I like that are also my size. Like, it's really hard for me. I never get shoes in stores. They never have my size in stores, which is understandable. And even online, I'm very limited to what kind of shoes I can get. So I don't really get to always get the shoes that I like or want. Sometimes I have to settle for other things, like different color waves, for example, which you guys will see throughout the video. So it's kind of a struggle, but, you know, I do what I can. I try. That's honestly why I get a lot of shoes, is because, like, I get them while they're hot. You know what I mean? Like, if I have to buy shoes, I'm like, okay, I need a bunch, dude. Because, like, it's really hard for me to get size 15. So let's go through them. Let's start right over here with the black and red new V2 Yeezys. This pair, along with this pair, like this, this is the green V2 Yeezys. This pair was sent to me by Sneaker Access, along with this pair and this pair. And honestly, if you do plan on picking up some V2s, just letting you guys know that they do run a little bit tighter. Like, these are actually all 14s. And they run tighter. So these are the tightest shoes I probably own that are tight on my feet. So I would, like, if you're a size 12, I recommend getting your size or even bigger, because they do run a little bit tighter. Like, if you're a 12, maybe get a 12.5. You know what I mean? So that's what I'm trying to say. So these are supposed to be the white ones. These are the copper. These are the red. And then these are the green, olive green. It doesn't really look too green on my screen. But maybe it does for you guys. Out of all these four pairs, I would say this is my favorite. Out of these four, I do like these a lot. Moving on from the Yeezers, I got the 750s. I think these are the first Yeezys I ever bought. Alex convinced me. I never bought Yeezys, and then he's like, yo, you should buy Yeezys. And then I did a like goal on a video, and then I bought these. I remember these were the first Yeezys I ever bought. Honestly, they're all overpriced. I'm not gonna tell you guys how much I paid for them, because So these are the 750s. I absolutely love those shoes. These are the Pyro Blacks. Definitely my favorite shoes that I own, because they kind of just go with everything. You know what I mean? Like, you could wear black shoes with everything. They're so fucking comfy. Like, Adidas killed it with the Yeezys, man. Like, I think they're some of the comfiest shoes there are. I love these a lot. So if you are looking to buy some Yeezys, these would be, like, your go-to. Because, you know what I mean? And I know a lot of people have them, but they are the comfiest shoes, in my opinion. Next pair, we got the Turtle Doves. These are the Yeezys Turtle Doves. I love the way these look. They get a little bit dirtier. Like, you see, like, over there, they get pretty dirty. But I do have, like, a shoe protector and shoe cleaner that I don't use, which I probably should. And then moving on, we got the Moon Rocks. These actually might have been my first ever Yeezys. I don't remember. These were my second. I think I bought the 750s, and then I bought these. I don't even know what color this is. Like, whitish gray? Like, gray. I would say gray, right? This is, like, a gray color. I really like these, too. I don't really wear them too often, to be honest. When I bought my Pirate Blacks, I didn't wear these for, like, 4 months. Literally. I have like a couple pairs of shoes here that I have never even worn. And I'll tell you why in a second. Not because I'm a scumbag or whatever. And then these are some very nice shoes as well. These kind of look like the Moon Rocks in a way. A little bit of a darker gray with, like, an orange stripe. These were the first ever V2s released. I believe these are the cheapest Yeezys I've bought in. Yeah, these ones were like the cheapest of them all. I mean, they're still running up the numbers, but these were the cheapest ones I bought. Super nice. I like the way they look. But the thing is, these don't really work with too many things, but I do love the way these look. I honestly don't wear them enough. Working our way down here, we got the Adidas Tubulars. Remember, I was in Canada with Alex, and we saw these on, like, East Bay or something, and I'm like, yo, these are fresh. And then we both copped a pair. So I really like the way these look as well. These were pretty cheap shoes. These were only like $100, and I really like the way they look, honestly. I wish this was more blacked out though, instead of the pattern, but the pattern isn't too bad anyways. I kind of fuck with it, honestly. So these are very durable, comfy, nice Adidas shoes. Now this, okay, kind of my biggest mistake. I don't know what I was doing that day. I don't know what went on in my head, but don't make fun, you know, you can make fun of me, it's fine. Please guess how much I spent on these. And I don't normally do dumb shit like this, but they looked cooler in the picture and I wanted Ultra Boost. So these are Ultra Boost. This is the Uncaged Hype Beast edition. There was only a few of these made, and I'm pretty sure the only reason I bought it was because there was only one left and it was size 15, and I was like, it's destiny. So yeah, as you guys can see, I am a 15 US, but this cost me $1,000. You know, I'm not worth, right? I barely even wear these, you know what I mean? Like, I don't wish I didn't cop these, but they are comfy though, you know? They are comfy, they are nice, but I just don't think they're worth $1,000. I don't know why I did that, but I guess I did. You know, they're limited edition, so there's not too many of them. Next, we have, I actually just bought these. These are the Kobe Mamba Instinct. There's a couple basketball shoes in here, by the way, guys. So yeah, these are, I wore them once, and they're very nice. I love the way these feel on my feet. And I think they're, you know, they're like lower cut basketball shoes. These are Kobe Bryant Mamba Instinct, you know what I mean? They're pretty cool, like these a lot. And this is what I was talking about, for example. Like, I really wanted to buy KDs. These are the KD9s, have yet to wear these because my thumb got injured right before I could even wear these. But these are the KD9s, they're in blue and white. I honestly wanted the all black pair or even the gray color, that was cool. But again, this is the only color they had in my size, so I kind of just went with it. I love blue anyways, but I don't normally wear like blue clothes. So, I mean, they are basketball shoes, so it doesn't really matter anyway. But yeah, those are really cool. I heard they're amazing shoes, have yet to wear them, so I have no idea. Now, these are my go-to basketball shoes, the Nike Hyperdunks Flyknit. I actually have two colorways. It's these ones and those right there. They're the exact same shoes, but this is actually one of the only shoes I was ever able to buy in stores. I remember I went into Foot Locker and I wanted to buy some basketball shoes and they actually had a size 15. So I copped literally for that reason because I got so excited that they had my size. These are cool though. It's like American colored, I think. I think that's what they're going for here. Truly one of the comfiest shoes ever. It comes with this little like sock thing. It's like part of the shoe, it's not a sock, you know what I mean? It's Flyknit, very nice Hyperdunk. I just bought these as well. I have yet to wear them, but I really wanted a pair of LeBrons, and I got these LeBron Soldiers. Have yet to try them out, but I hear they're good. We'll let you guys know more when I try them out. They're pretty fresh. I do like the way they look. They're diesel shoes, very diesel shoes. So these are mostly basketball and stuff, right? I don't even like these shoes, okay? I don't even like them. But I did because they're Adidas and like they were like honestly mad cheap, and I bought a pair of white and then a pair in black down there. But they're just the bounces, nothing, they're not that cool, but you know, they work. They're just like for, these are gym shoes, you know what I mean? I don't wear these out when I'm wearing Adidas gym stuff. And these are the same as the white ones, but in black. So this is like a nice little black bounce shoe. You know, a little bit nicer. I like these more than the white ones. Now, these are some great shoes. I do love these shoes a lot. These are the Kyries. They're very comfy. I do recommend if you like Kyrie Irving. They're very, I mean, it doesn't really matter if you like Kyrie or not, but I'm just saying they're good shoes. And if you like Kyrie a lot, then I would recommend. I've only wore these a few times. These were one of the first, actually, I bought these before I even moved into the Faze house, honestly. These are my Air Force Ones. I just bought them because I just wanted Jordans, honestly. And I bought these like a long ass time ago. I don't wear them too often. I've only worn them maybe like 10 times total. Now, this is an unworn shoe, okay? So I wanted the infrareds really bad, right? Because I love the way these look, even though I got them so dirty. And I think these were running on Flight Club or East Bay. I don't remember where. I think actually, yeah, Flight Club. And I think they were running on $300 on Flight Club. But then I saw a 2-in-1 where it came with the black and red ones and then also the white and blue ones for like $400. So I'm like, oh, it's an extra $100. I get an extra pair of shoes. Fuck it. So that's why I bought them. So it came with the white ones as well. But I have never worn these before. Literally never. Like, these are mad clean. This is the first pair of expensive basketball shoes I bought when I was in Flight Club in LA in 2015. I remember I went in there and these were the Space Jams from the movie Space Jam. You guys ever seen that? These are the shoes Michael Jordan wore, and these were some of the original ones, I think. And I remember we were in Flight Club and I got excited and I wanted the Space Jams. They only had one size 15 left, as you guys. Oh, it doesn't show size? Why does that show the size? I don't know, I'm trying to show you guys the size, but yeah. I went into Flight Club and they only had like one size 15 left, so I was like, destiny, dude, it's destiny. I never really get shoes in stores, so I get excited whenever I do. These are some Curries that I bought. I don't really wear these anymore, but they're nice basketball shoes. I'll wear them if I go to like maybe an outdoor court or something. And then these are another pair of Curries that I have. Don't really know what the difference is, but I don't even remember buying them both. For some reason, I've always thought these were the same shoes, but they're not. I don't know. And then these are the Hyperdunks I told you guys about, like the same one as these. They're the same shoes, but I love these ones a lot. These are my go-to. Like, this is, if you catch me playing basketball at the gym, this is what I'm 99% of the time wearing. You know what I mean? That's my go-to. And then this is my first pair of basketball shoes. When I got into basketball, I mean, I've had basketball shoes growing up, but I've never, like, this is when I first started playing basketball. This is the first pair of shoes I bought. These are the Derrick Roses. They're Adidas. They're honestly pretty shitty. I'm not gonna lie. I don't really like them. I never wear these. I wore it for the first like 3 months I played basketball, and I haven't worn it since. I don't really, they're okay. You know, they're okay, they're just not that good. And then moving on to the last three pairs of shoes, these are my Gucci's. These are my first pair of Gucci shoes. Love the way these look. These go good with a few outfits. I mean, it's honestly just for like one or two outfits with that hat, and I have a belt that matches it as well. And then that, you know, that Gucci hat I have? It's like this hat, but it's this theme. So instead of black, it's like that. And then I like that hat with these shoes and the belt that matches it too. So it's pretty cool. And then as you guys can see, I literally have no white shoes at all. So I needed to cop some white shoes. So I bought some more white Gucci's. I like, these ones are honestly probably one of my favorite pairs of shoes. I love these shoes. These are so fucking nice. They feel good. And I just absolutely love these shoes. Last pair of shoes, I mean, honestly, I wish I didn't get these, but I do like them a lot, don't get me wrong, but these are my first pair of Louis Vuitton shoes. I love them, I do think they're nice, but the thing is, they're leather, and they're size 14, so it's one size smaller, and I just winged it. I said, fuck it, you know, it'll be fine, and it's really, really tight on my feet. This is actually, I said the Yeezys were, this is the tightest shoe on my feet, so I only wear it if I'm really trying to stunt. I honestly rarely wear these shoes. I don't wear them enough, but they're super tight. But I do like the way they look. I'll wear them sometimes. It depends how I'm feeling. So yeah, guys, that is my shoe collection. I threw in the flip-flops at the end. It's because I know some people know that I have these. And I wanted to actually tell you guys something about the Gucci flops versus the Louis Vuitton flops. So for the longest time, I wore these Gucci flops, right? And this happens on the side of them. Like, do you see what's going on here? Like, it gets fucked up on the left side, right? Or the right side, left side, yeah. Same thing with these ones. And then same thing with these ones. And they keep getting fucked up. And I went into Gucci and I was like, hey, like, does this happen often? Like, cause like my Gucci flops are so fucked up. And then she's like, yeah, literally every single customer that buys them has that issue. So everyone, like it's something to do with the flops, I guess the way that, I don't know why they wouldn't do something to get around that. I personally think this makes it look ugly. You know what I mean? It makes them look like worn down, even though like they're fucking flops. How are you really gonna wear them down? You know what I mean? I'm just letting you guys know that is an issue with the Gucci flops if you ever plan on buying them. I mean, they're nice, they're comfy, I think they're great. But I bought these recently and I prefer these a lot more. They're so durable, no scratching whatsoever yet. And I've worn them actually a lot. My bros have worn them. They all think these are nicer than the Gucci ones as well. So these are the Louis Vuitton flops. I really like these. They don't have these anymore. This is out of season, I think. So they don't really have these anymore. But the Gucci ones do look nicer though. They do. I do, because these are so subtle. But I like subtle. I think subtle's nice. And yeah, those ones are a little bit flashier, but they are nice as well. So yeah, guys, that is my shoe collection. And a garbage bag right there. What's up?
Wow, dude, there's so many shoes here.
Yeah.
Cow?
You can have them all.
All?
You and the fans, you guys can all split them. Oh, but dude, what do they have to do, dude? What do they have to do?
I don't know, bro. I mean, you just said I can have them, so I mean, I'm just gonna kind of take them before you change them.
Take them all, yeah! You're actually just taking all the shoes. I really wouldn't care if you... No, you took the Gucci's. You took one Gucci. Put it back, dude. Put it back. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. I will see you guys in tomorrow's video. It has been your boy, Norm Chat or Faith. Check out the vlog if you guys missed it. And we'll see you guys in the next Faith House video. I'm a YouTuber. I live with my bros. We make YouTube videos together. And we'll see you guys later. Peace out, everybody. I'm going for a thumbs up. Peace out, everybody.